Well, today we continue our Landmarks in the Land series, putting a spotlight on some of the most iconic places in Northeast Ohio and learning the backstory of what makes each so special. This week, we're visiting an anchor of the downtown Cleveland skyline, Terminal Tower. It has stood as the beacon of our city for nearly 100 years.
This is the structure that everybody knows.
Standing tall in the Cleveland skyline.
This is still the focal point of the city.
Is a structure synonymous with the city itself.
People are drawn to this building for a number of reasons, and I think it's just an iconic building in the city and makes anybody want to be a part of it.
Terminal Tower may no longer be the tallest building in Cleveland, but it still holds the title for best known.
It is indeed the symbol of Cleveland.
So how did the land's most recognizable landmark come to be? Historian John Grabowski says it all comes down to suburbanization.
It's a story about real estate, creating Shaker Heights, and then trying to get an electric railroad to go from Shaker Heights into downtown Cleveland, and knowing that you needed a terminal in downtown Cleveland.
In the early 1900s, the Van Swearingen brothers were buying and developing real estate in the Cleveland area, including a plan for an upscale suburb they called Shaker Heights. But they needed a way to get people from that new community into the city.
So the Van Swearingen brothers, O.P. and M.J., Oris Paxton and Manus James, became owners of railroads. They become real estate entrepreneurs, and they decide they finally have the land. They get it cleared by the city to build on the southwest corner of the square.
What started as plans for a rail station called Cleveland Union Terminal morphed into a 52-story, 708-foot-tall skyscraper. When it was completed in 1927, it was the tallest building in the country outside of New York City.
I think this adds to what one would call the legitimization of Cleveland as a major city. And on one corner, you've got this building from the 1920s that says, Cleveland is here, Cleveland is a transportation center.
The tower became not only a transportation center for residents of the suburbs that followed, but a downtown hub with offices, shops, and restaurants, bringing together Higbee's department store on one side and the Hotel Cleveland on the other. In 2016, real estate group K&D bought the tower and created 300 apartment units with amenities.
This was about a $105 million project in total, including the apartment renovations and everything. So we put a lot of money back into the building to make sure that it can be a long-standing, you know, functioning, wonderful building like it's always been.
Matt Driggs, K&D's VP of Commercial Real Estate, says it's important to recreate a downtown community to attract retail, business, and young people.
Yeah.
While also preserving a part of Cleveland's history, seen here in the Van Swearingen's residence in the tower.
So during Prohibition, this is where they could have stored their booze.
Once sparked by the suburbanization of Cleveland, Terminal Tower is now drawing people back into the heart of the city.
What we're seeing is a rebirth of downtown Cleveland, not as a business center, but as a residential center.
One of the many historic buildings modernizing and adapting to serve as home to a new generation of Clevelanders.
Public Square will be kind of become like a neighborhood, and Terminal Tower can still be like the centerpiece of that neighborhood on Public Square, which is what I think Public Square should probably be.
Terminal Tower reaching ever upwards towards the sky and continuing to push Cleveland into the future.
And Terminal Tower was the tallest building in the state of Ohio until the completion of Key Tower in 1991. It remains the second tallest building in the state. But I thought this was so cool because how many people probably recognize the tower, right, as the symbol, but
yeah.
Really the history behind it, I feel like maybe you wouldn't necessarily know.
I mean, I had no idea that there were even apartment complexes
right.
within that building, so I feel like that's pretty historic to be able to live in a building such as that. And my favorite part of the building is seeing it lit up in different colors.
Right.
Because I feel like you sometimes step out the door and you never know what you're going to get.
Mm-hmm.
Christmas time, red, green. I mean, today,
yeah.
I don't know if I'd step out and what color it will be. So I think it's always
yeah.
a surprise.
Definitely. And the view from those apartments, too, like you mentioned, so cool living
oh,
in
yeah.
history. Some of them, I was there kind of in the wintertime doing
mm-hmm.
this story. And you look out on the public square, and that was when the ice rink was there.
Mm-hmm.
Everything was lit up. So just so beautiful to feel like you can really be a part of Cleveland's history and the fabric of the city. Look outside, see all it has to, you know, has to offer.
Yeah.
So really cool little melding there, I think, of what the future of Cleveland looks like, but also respecting and reflecting on the past, too.
Of course, we have to reflect to obviously remember where we are currently,
right.
too.